Hello, good morning, students. I am Arvind Soni, your English teacher. Hope you all are fine and healthy in your home. Today I am going to teach you first lesson of course book, The Royal Parade. The Royal Parade, what is the meaning of Royal Parade? Parade, a group of people, vehicles and animals that march slowly through a street on the day of a festival or celebration. Let us see this picture. There are some animals like elephant and horses, some soldiers and common peoples. Starter. Royal parade have been an important way to celebrate festival or events. Look at this painting of royal parade from 17th century India. Means this picture is related to 17th century. Okay, discuss with your partner what you see in the painting. You can discuss with your partner what is in this painting. Number one, who are the people in the painting? And his answer is, the people in the painting are royal soldiers with lances and flags and common people who have come to watch the parade and be a part of the procession. Okay? Come to the second question. What do you think these people are celebrating? And his answer is, the people are perhaps celebrating a royal victory or a festival. Okay? Number third, which animal are part of the royal parade? Why? Here, see this picture carefully. There are two types of animals. First, elephant and second, horses. Okay? And answer of this question is, elephants and horses are the animals partaking in the royal parade. Why? Because elephants were often part of the royal army, and as a result of royal parades, due to their strength, courage and ferocity,
they also added to the pomp of a king and the success of a conqueror. Horses were used for their speed, efficiency and reliability. They were heavily relied upon during wars. Get it? Number question 4. Where do you think these people are going? Where do you think these people are going? The people are perhaps heading towards the heart of the village, town, city, whatever, where the commerce, entertainment, shops and political power are concentrated. Okay? Now, come to the main topic, main content of this lesson. Read this story and answer the question that follow. One day, in the late summer in 1638, the sun was rising over the thick forest in Nagarhol. Nagarhol is the name of place. Jaya bathed and filled her pot from the Kabini River. As she walked home in her wet Pavadai Shati, it's a kind of dress material, a skirt and a blouse worn by little girl in South India. Okay? She called out to Deva cheerfully. Deva, it's a character of this story. Deva. Who is Deva? Deva, the elephant calf. He is Deva. Hopped means jump out. Out of the thicket. Thicket means just like a forest. Look here, thicket, a dense group of trees or bushes. On their days, Jaya and Deva would play in the river, splashing about. Splashing means sprinkle about and spraying water at each other. Both are playing in the forest, nearby forest, river, and they sprinkle water to each other. But today, Jaya gently held Deva's trunk and said, "Deva, today Appa might return from Mysuru. I am going to run home." Jaya's father was the chief of the biggest tribe in Nagahol. The king of Mysuru had sent his guard to the forest to summon him. Summon, look here, officially call someone to be present. The king wanted advice on herbal medicines. Herbal means something Ayurvedic, related to Ayurvedic. Jaya's father had taken special herbs and honey to the royal court a week ago. "I will bring you some Mysore pak." Mysore pak, a South Indian sweet. Jaya hoped her father had remembered to keep his promise about the sweet. Deva trumpets loud cry of an elephant. Happily, as she saw his little friend hurrying home, balancing the pot on her head. Balancing, she has a pot over head and he managed the balance of the pot on her head. Okay. When Jaya neared her home, she saw people crowding there. Crowding means assemble. "Ah, Appa is already home," she said. She poured the water from the pot into the cleaned trough, an open container from which animals can eat or drink. Okay. In the cow sheds and run into the hut. The cows moaned the sound of cow and walked to the fresh water. "Hope the cows are thirsty," and when he saw the fresh water, they moored and walked to the fresh water for drinking. Jaya's father lifted her up and seated her on his lap with a big smile. He was telling the people from his tribe about Mysuru, the new king there. The magnificent means splendid. Palace, a throne made of pure gold. The wide roads, the crowded markets, where everything was available, and the huge temples. He said the city was getting ready for a big festival called Dasara. Dasara, a festival celebrating in India. He said during the festival, the king himself leads a grand parade of royal deities, noble families, military officers, soldiers, dancers, camels, horses, and elephants. Okay, students, now we stop here. Hope all of you are understand this chapter. If you have any kind of problem related to this chapter, you can ask me on my personal number. Okay.